So we now have this very basic picture that says that we have state space. I'll draw the full XY space. And we have a trajectory through state space. That is the evolution or the change of the system over time. And by the way, we're going to adopt a color scheme that is, hopefully I'm going to follow absolutely religiously throughout this presentation. And I definitely want us to think this way because there are four critical pieces of structure and we're going to use four different colors to represent them, which serves as a useful mnemonic. The state space and the state vector are always going to be in black. The trajectory is always going to be in red. And then there's two more things coming. And here comes the first one. So the question is, what we asked this question before. We said, what makes this state point go to the left rather than to the right? What gives the curve the shape that it has? And at that point, we didn't have an answer. We're now going to answer that question. What tells the state point where to go? And the answer is the model. Now, what is a model? Because this is something that we're going to be doing a lot of. A model in our hands takes a very, very standard form. We start with a state variable. Let's say that state variable is x. And we write a little prime symbol next to it. And you read this as x prime. Now, what is x prime? X prime, you may think of as the change in x in, of course, a unit of time. And so now we're going to write the state variable here, and we're going to put this prime symbol next to it. And now we're going to ask, what changes x? What are the factors that make x change? In particular, what makes x go up? What makes x go down? And then we're going to put those factors over here, and we're going to put factors that what makes x go up. And of course, that's going to have a positive sign. And then we're going to subtract from that what makes x go down. So that, of course, depends upon the science and the setup and the details of the particular situation. Let's start with an amazingly simple example. I want to talk about a bathtub. And the bathtub is going to have a certain amount of water in it. And I'm going to call the amount of that water left in the bathtub x. And then what is going to change x? Well, in this first example, the only thing that's going to change x is a faucet flowing into the bathtub. Well, then in that case, we can write the equation x prime equals faucet. That's what makes x go up, is the water that is coming from the faucet. But of course, faucet is just an English word. We need to put some math in there. And so what you ultimately need to do is you need to specify mathematically what is the faucet doing. Well, the faucet is adding water. And it's adding water, let's just again assume for this first day of class model, let's assume that the faucet is flowing at a constant rate. Let's say it's 10 gallons per minute. So notice that the flow rate of the faucet, if X is in gallons, then X prime, or the flow rate, is in gallons per minute. And so our first simple change equation is now in front of us. It's X prime equals 10. And we're going to call that a change equation. So our first change equation, and a change equation, another word for a change equation, is a model. And so our first model or change equation is the model X prime equals 10. Now you ask, what do you do with that? And that's an excellent question that we're going to deal with today, but I'm going to hold that off right now. Right now, we just have this change equation. The change equation is X prime equals 10. Now, that's not too interesting. And in particular, we have been talking early on about feedback and the importance of feedback. You will notice that there is no feedback in this equation, X prime equals 10. And after the bath overflows onto the bathroom floor, X prime equals 10. And after the house is floating, X prime equals 10. There is nothing in this model that allows for anything like feedback or turning off the faucet or the flow rate decreasing. This is a fixed inflow, and this is the model, and that's what's going to happen. But that's not very interesting. So let's have a better bathtub model. And now the bathtub model is going to have an inflow, which is the faucet. And it's also going to have a little outflow. And the outflow is going to be the drain. And the drain is going to put out water like that. So now we ask, what is the change equation for this setup? And we agreed that the inflow was just going to be a constant inflow of 10 gallons an hour. But now what is the outflow? It's interesting because the outflow is not constant. The outflow rate depends upon the water pressure. And the water pressure on that outflow is going to depend upon how much water is still there. The water is going to drain faster when X is large than it will when X is small. So X, the amount of water left, is going to feed back onto the outflow rate. And so we can write X prime equals 10 minus outflow. And now we need to put a number on the outflow. And we agreed that the outflow is proportional to the amount of water left. So if the outflow is proportional to the amount of water left, that amounts to saying that the outflow is equal to kx for some scalar k, because that's what the word proportional means. So now we have a model, it's a little more interesting, which is x prime equals 10 minus kx. And k is the outflow rate proportionality constant. What determines the value of k? Clearly, It's the width of this outflow pipe. If the outflow pipe is very wide, K is very large, and the water is lost very quickly. If the outflow pipe is very narrow, then K is very small, and the outflow, the water is lost very slowly. K is therefore a very interesting example, and we're going to be seeing this a lot, of what is called a parameter. It's a parameter in our model, which means that we don't yet have a definite equation until we specify a value for K. And that value for K right now will remain fixed. Let's just say K equals 0.2. That then gives us an actual definite model, 10 minus 0.2x. And this is our first sort of interesting model, because you could not immediately tell me what kind of behavior this model predicts. So this is how we make a model. We write down our parameters, and we write down our state variables, and then we just ask what makes them go up and what makes them go down.